Welcome to Machine Learning Spring 2023. This is about course logistics. There's a course website right there. There's a link to it on Canvas also. All the lectures will be posted there. The slides and such things. Also, there will be links to videos as we go along. For discussion, we'll be using Canvas, the Canvas discussion board. The course website has a link, but of course you have access to Canvas anyway. All of you should have access to Canvas. On Canvas, you might see that your class is CS5350. Some of you may think, but I signed up for something else. So it is CS5350, 6350, and DS4350. I just clubbed them into one Canvas thing so that I don't lose my mind and my TAs don't lose theirs. Quick show of hands, how many people here are in 5350? And how many in 6350? And any DS? Okay, so we have a good mix of all three. And you know which section you belong to. And it shouldn't really matter because Canvas shows up as one thing. This class is, of course, in person for the semester, but it's also available on Zoom. I see that there are a few people on Zoom already. In case you need to avail yourself of that opportunity for any reason, feel free to do that. The Zoom link is available on Canvas. I sent out an announcement this morning. You should have access to Zoom. The lecture recordings will be posted on YouTube after the class, and the details will be available on the class website as we go along. I think I made a mistake in the announcement that I posted. I corrected it, that the lecture will be live streamed on YouTube. This seems beyond my capability. I just can't get live streaming on YouTube to work with this laptop of mine. So I'll record it and post the videos afterwards. In case the a side effect of the fact that the lectures will be posted on YouTube is that in case you don't want to show up in the video, it doesn't matter. There's no video here. Just don't show up in my slides. But I do encourage participation. Let that not stop you from asking questions. I believe that participating in a class and interacting with a professor is important for understanding the material. And we are going to get into some really complex material very soon. So it's in your best interest to kind of interact. We'll be using Canvas for all sorts of any announcements that we have, and also for managing things like homework submissions and all kinds of submissions and grades. When do we meet? Tuesdays and Thursdays, as I said, lunchtime. Or 12:25 to 1:45. I'm your instructor. This is what I look like without a mask. Not that you're going to see much of that. My office, you can find my office. And I plan to have office hours after the Tuesday lecture every week, except for today, because there's apparently some big announcement that's happening at 2:00 today that I'm curious about. We have three teaching assistants. All three of them are seated in the front row here. Can you just stand up and wave for the class? All my teaching assistants took machine learning in the last maybe 3 to 4 years, right? And they all got an A. So they know everything. So if I'm not able to teach, they can easily jump in and take over. So we have Ashim, Maitre, and Aman. I found out that Amanpreet likes to go by Aman, so I'm going to cross that out. They have their office hours. This information is on the class website also. I also posted this as this information on Canvas. And, you know, please use the office hours to please take advantage of all our office hours. As I said, I strongly encourage class participation. It helps understanding, especially complex material. There are multiple ways to participate in class. In person, it's quite simple. Ask questions, answer questions. Simple. Don't ask each other questions, ask me questions. You can always talk to each other afterwards. If you have, this is for Zoom. This is for, if you are on Zoom, if you have questions or comments, you can either type it or you can unmute yourself and ask the question. There's some possibility that unmuting will not work for reasons that I don't understand. You can just type a question and I will read it out to the class. I'm always looking for new ideas for, you know, increasing participation. We are looking for new suggestions always. And, you know, if you feel like you have any interesting ideas, please let me know. I'm not fond of using clickers and such things because they seem forced, but you know, I'm always looking for ideas. Speaking of sending us messages, use the discussion board to talk to each other, use the discussion board to talk to us. If you need to send private messages or confidential stuff, you can send messages through Canvas. If you send an email to us, to our email inbox, unfortunately, given how much email that I receive, it might get drowned out. I'll get to it, but as some of you have already noticed, I am a little slow with responding to emails if it shows up, but if it's on Canvas, one of us will answer the question. Look for announcements on Canvas. Any questions about any of these things? Usually there are no questions. I mean, what's there to ask about sending an email? In terms of what the prerequisites are, you need to know basic probabilities and linear algebra. You need to know some statistics. You need to have enough programming skills that you see an algorithm and you can implement it in a programming language of your choice. Typically, a programming language of your choice is Python. I don't necessarily know why, but that seems to be the case. And you should also have enough CS skills to be able to reason about the algorithm. What I mean by that is you should be able to see an algorithm and say, is it a linear algorithm? Is it exponential? Fantastic. And that's covered in your prerequisite classes for an undergrad. For grad students who don't have such prerequisites, I can point you to resources. The resources tab on the class website has a collection of these resources. There is no required textbook. Yes, there's a question somewhere. Was there a question? Okay. It's mostly the application. It's really the application. In fact, I was talking to one of my colleagues the other day. The way linear algebra is taught in math classes is kind of boring. Don't say this to me. It's recorded, right? So don't say this to people, but I think it's boring because machine learning is such a fantastic application of linear algebra. It's where you can kind of get this really cool intuition for the whole field. So it's mostly the applications. Yes.
So it says something quite small. I'll ask you about it. But based off of that statement, and some other statements you said about not learning specific tools for other like theory, if you're not going to be like, you should use libraries.
No, you should not use libraries. You should not use you should not use machine learning libraries. That is an important requirement for this class. I'll tell you why. It makes no sense. I mean, how can you learn about the internals of a library if you just issue a function call and say, I'm done? Imagine going to a compiler's class and say, they teach you how to implement a compiler, and you instead just take the C++ compiler and say, I'm done. Like, how do you actually get to learn this stuff if you don't look into it and make one of your own? So you should not use a machine learning library. As I said, there's no required textbook. The class is self-contained. Any material that I ask, that I insist that you should read, I'll make sure that it's available for you. The lectures will be posted on the class website. And there's a growing collection of resources around linear algebra and probability and logic and such things on the class website that I encourage you to take advantage of. Yes.
Earlier, you were saying that there are some sections where you could recommend textbooks for us to people can hear you on the
Yes. Is
there going to be a section on
the course website? Every lecture comes with, if you go to the lectures page on the course website, it's like a list of topics. If you click the link, you'll see like additional readings on every lecture, including this one, I think. In fact, that's where you'll find the badges data. In terms of what you have to do to earn your grade, there will be about 6 or 7 assignments, which will be the bulk of your grade, 55% of the points that you have. There's going to be a midterm and a final and a class project. So I'll keep you busy for the semester. This class is a mix of grad students and undergrads, and I don't think it's fair to put grad students and undergrads on the same sort of scale, so I will curve them differently. That said, historically, the best performance in the class has often been an undergrad, even without curving. Just letting you know, and for the undergrads, it's a you know something to feel happy about. For the grad students, here's a challenge. There will be curving. This is a question that keeps coming up. All your scores will be curved. Homeworks, there will be 6 or 7 homeworks, roughly 1 every 2 weeks. And sometimes grad students may have to do extra work in the homework. Most homework, but not all, will involve a programming component. And your code, your homeworks should run on the CAD machines. Those of you who are not in some sort of in the school of computing, if you want to know what is this CAD business, just search for it. You'll find resources for it on the class website also. Your code must run on the CAD machine. We will not edit your code to make it run because then we are doing your homework. We can talk about this as we go along. We strongly prefer that you use Python. And this I say with a bit of pain in my heart because I don't particularly like the language. We strongly prefer you use Python simply because it has become the de facto language for data science in terms of when you go out there in the wild and start applying the things that you learn, you'll be familiar with these things. We will accept only digital submissions. Please, please, please do not submit anything handwritten. I say please, but I'm not going to grade anything that's handwritten. Or my TAs, I have instructed them not to grade anything that's handwritten, mostly because, you know, people's handwritings are awful.
I thought you just talked about handwriting.
But... Yes. But, you know, sir, I've noticed that students and faculty included tend to somehow break the system. We tend to be the outliers. The late policy for this class is rather simple. If you feel like you want to submit something late, you get 24 hours. You can submit anything you want 24 hours late, and the cost for that is 10% of your grade. So it's a choice you make. The options are, you submit on time, whatever grade you get is the grade you get. You submit within the next 24 hours, you lose 10% of the points. You submit after that, you lose 100% of the points. In the 24 hour window, a 90 would become an 81. Last few minutes left. Lots of stuff to do, so I'm going to kind of go fast. There's going to be a class project, and the idea is you use ideas from the lectures to kind of show me what you learned, and it'll be a competitive project. I say competitive in the sense that all of you will work on the same data set, and there will be a leaderboard where your algorithms will compete against each other. And your position on the leaderboard is not going to determine your grade. I just want to make that clear. If you do all the right things, you will get the full grade. But the competition, I've noticed, makes students very excited. There will be several milestones for the projects, and the class website has more information. There's a milestone that's coming up, but I'll talk about it in the next lecture. There are a whole bunch of class policies. I'm sure you've seen all of these before, but please, please go over the class, the syllabus on the class website. In particular, the course operates under the School of Computing policy. And there's some discussion about CAD. The TAs are handling it. The course operates under the School of Computing policy. One of the important policies is that I will not tolerate cheating. I want you to collaborate, but I will not allow you to cheat. I mean, you are welcome to cheat, but you will lose the grade. Let's put it that way. The first offense, you fail the submission, homework, or whatever. The second offense, I'll kick you out of the class. And that sounds a bit harsh, but it ruins the experience for everyone. It makes no sense for you to cheat because then you don't learn anything, and it's unfair to the rest of your the class. Your submissions should be your own. You should acknowledge sources. You should not use online resources, even if they are freely available or if they are automated systems like ChatGPT. Don't let it write your homework. No group submissions also, because it makes no sense. If you need any accommodation, I'll get you in the room. If you need any accommodation, please reach out to me soon. I'll work with the university's Center for Disability and Access, and they tend to take a little bit of time. So please do this sooner rather than later. There are additional policies on safety and harassment and such things on the class website. Basically, I want you to stay safe. Don't harass anybody and be well. That's the policy. There are COVID guidelines also. We'll be following the university resources. For reasons that are my own, I will be lecturing with a mask. So, and you're welcome to wear a mask as well. I'm sure you're all familiar with these policies. I don't think I need to repeat everything. If you are not, go to that website. It gives you all the details. I think this was officially updated for 2023. So even if you've seen it before, go check it out. And in case any of you need masks, I plan to come with masks to the class and I'll leave them here. You're welcome to use them. What I would like to know is who you are. There's a whole bunch of you in this class, and rather than just talking to this amorphous blob of people, I want to know who you are. There'll be a survey on Canvas that just lets me know who you are, and you can answer all of it or any of it or none of it as you want. And it'll help me kind of tailor the class better to you. So I encourage you to do it. It should be available on Canvas before the end of today. One final thing. I saved the best thing for the last, depending best or worst, depending on how you want. There's a homework out there. There will be a homework out there in the next hour. It's the homework zero. It's due in 1 week. It's mostly to kind of get yourself familiar or reacquainted with all the prerequisites. It's a quiz on Canvas. You get 1 week, two attempts, and I'll keep the highest score. It's just to talk, you know, it's like a quiz about linear algebra, probabilities, and a little bit of algebra. Final thing, this class is oversubscribed. Some of you are not registered for the class. If you are unable to register in the next couple of days, we'll figure it out. There's a waiting list, and I'll be handing out permission code